Is our guest famous for traveling?
Is our guest famous for traveling?
Yes.
Is she also a newspaper columnist?
Yes.
Did she ever occupy the White House?
Yes.
Is it Mrs. Franklin Delano Roosevelt?
Mrs. Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
Anna Eleanor Roosevelt, commonly known as Eleanor Roosevelt, was born on October 11, 1884 to parents Elliot and Anna Roosevelt. Eleanor was born in a society where women had few rights and an inferior position in society and politics. Eleanor's parents died when she was still young. She went to live with her grandmother, who then sent her to Allenswood Academy. There, Eleanor met the feminist headmistress and women's activist Marie Silvestre, a woman who influenced Eleanor's character and outlook on life. After 3 years at Allenwood, she returned home. A few years later, she married her fifth cousin, politician Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Since Franklin was a politician, he traveled pretty often, leaving Eleanor with plenty of free time. As an outlet to put her time into, Eleanor volunteered and dedicated her time to injured soldiers returning from World War I through programs like Red Cross and Navy Relief. In the midst of Franklin's political career, he was diagnosed with polio, making it difficult for him to travel and make appearances. Eleanor motivated Franklin to still be active in politics, so she began campaigning and making appearances for him. This was the first time a woman really ever became involved in politics. She also joined the Women's Trade Union League, Women's City Club, became an active member of the Democratic Party, and much more. In 1933, Franklin Delano Roosevelt became the 32nd President of the United States. Eleanor became depressed because she knew that if Franklin became president, she would have to give up her political roles and causes she supported. The primary role of the president's wife was hosting, but she hoped to change that and create another image for the First Lady. She began holding press conferences with only women reporters to support women's privileges and giving speeches to discuss issues she thought were important. Eleanor also expressed her opinions through newspaper columns called My Day, in which she wrote about many topics such as her personal life, women's rights, racial equality, and much more. In 1939, famous African-American singer Marian Anderson requested to sing at the Constitution Hall in Washington, D.C., but the DAR refused to let her sing because of her race. Eleanor Roosevelt, being a champion of civil rights, resigned from the DAR in a letter reading, "However, I am in complete disagreement with the attitude taken in refusing Constitution Hall to a great artist. You have set an example which seems to me unfortunate, and I feel obliged to send in to you my resignation. You had an opportunity to lead in an enlightened way, and it seems to me that your organization has failed." Eleanor set up her own concert at the Lincoln Memorial, where she allowed Marian Anderson to sing. This concert also became known as the Freedom's Concert. Eleanor was all for racial equality. She even invited the NAACP Executive Secretary, Walter White, and several presidents of African American universities to the White House to discuss the problem of racism. On December 7, 1941, when the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor, many Americans became furious and discriminated against the Japanese Americans. Eleanor Roosevelt wrote a letter saying that not all Japanese Americans take fault in the bombing, which is why we should not be prejudiced towards them, for some of them are guilty of nothing. As the U.S. entered World War II in 1941, Eleanor's job became even more difficult as she was rarely ever home. She spent the majority of her time traveling around the U.S. to boost nationalism and raise support for the war. She also encouraged women to engage in workforce that men typically did. For example, she urged women to apply for jobs in the military. Eleanor believed that women were just as equal as men. In 1945, President Franklin Delano Roosevelt died due to ill health, ending Eleanor's title as First Lady. Still, even after her life in the White House, she continued to remodel the way people viewed women and politics. Eleanor continued to travel around the U.S. even after FDR's death, acting as the United States' unofficial ambassador. She also continued writing her newspaper column, spoke on radio stations, and wrote a few books, including her autobiography, The Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and other books mostly about her life as First Lady. In 1946, Eleanor became a member of the United Nations. She would go on to become the chairman of the committee that wrote the Declaration of Human Rights. This was possibly one of her most greatest accomplishments because this document was an advancement towards equality for all humans.
I'm going to read you the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Now, therefore, the General Assembly proclaims this Universal Declaration of Human Rights as a common standard of achievement for all peoples and all nations, to the end that every individual and every organ of society, keeping this declaration constantly in mind, shall strive by teaching and education to promote respect for these rights and freedoms, and by progressive measures, national and international, to secure their universal and effective recognition and observance.
On November 7, 1962, Eleanor Roosevelt died of cardiac failure, but her fight for freedom, justice, and peace for all was one that lasted a lifetime, not just for her years as First Lady. Eleanor Roosevelt left a legacy on America due to the fact that she was one of the first few women to be actively involved in politics, an advocate for human rights, and known for redefining what it means to be the First Lady of the United States of America.